Hello, my dear students. I hope everything is going on well with you and your family. Do you know I was very excited to meet you because the teachers of last year have given a good remark about you. But unfortunately, we couldn't meet each other. So let's use this platform for teaching and learning. So before stepping on to the chapter, let's see what is the subject we are going to deal with. As compared to the last year, you were learning the same subject as a part of your English core. But today, you are going to learn this as a separate subject because you people have grown up. So we are going to make a new subject for you. So let me introduce a new subject for you. Environmental studies. Environmental studies, when you hear the name of this subject, maybe it's too long for you. We can shorten it up and we can call it as EVS. So when you hear EVS, you may be wondering what is this EVS. EVS is a subject which helps you to interact with the surrounding. Interact with the surrounding means you will know about your surrounding. If you want to know about your surrounding, you should be knowing what is present in the surrounding. So this EVS subject will help you to understand or learn the things ranging from the immediate environment. Immediate environment means plants, animals, air, soil, water, clothes, your body parts, as well as you can learn about the wider environment. Wider environment like your neighborhood, about your school, all these things. So you understood that we have so many things around us. So we must be knowing what all these things are named by. For example, you are seated in front of the laptop or maybe in the on tab. There are so many things. You just look around and see. There are so many things around you. Maybe your parents will be seated next to you. Maybe you have your laptop in the front. You may be sitting on the chair. The walls, there will be walls around. The clock will be hanging on the wall. If you step outside the room, outside your house, if you see around, you can see so many other things. You can see your beautiful garden. There may be flowers blooming. There will be butterflies fluttering around. There may be road in front of you. The people will be walking here and there. So many things will be there around you. But these things we can categorize or we can group them in different names, such as natural things, man-made things, non-living things, and living things. So today we will learn our first chapter, that is living and non-living things. Living and non-living things are the things that you see around you. Okay, so some may be living and some may be non-living. So we should know how we can categorize that into a living thing and a non-living thing. So as I said earlier, there may be so many things around us. So one or two or three things we can categorize in different names. So let's see first what is a living thing. Living things are those things which have life. Right? Living things are those things which have life. Means that human beings have life. Right? Why do we say we have life? Because we are able to breathe, we are able to feel, we are able to move, we can sense certain things. That is why we say we human beings are living things. For example, we see the first picture. It's a picture of a butterfly. We can see whether this butterfly has the quality of living things or has a feature of living things. So let's take butterfly first. So butterfly has a feature. Let's check the first feature, that whether the butterfly are able to breathe. Can they breathe? Yes, definitely butterfly can breathe. So let's check the second feature. Can the butterfly move? Yes, butterfly can move. Okay, let's see the next feature. Can the butterfly need food to grow? Yes, butterfly need food to grow. You can see certain pictures here. All these pictures shows they are living things. First is a butterfly, then is a sunflower, cow, tree and a girl. You may be wondering why the flower and tree is there in the picture group. But I will tell you why it is there in this group. because plants as well as trees as well as flowers, they are included in the living things. They included in the group of living things. Okay, why I'll say they, you will definitely ask, they are not able to move around. They are not able to move around, but we know that plants and trees move in the direction, they grow in the direction of the sunlight, as well as the roots can move around. So that is why the plants as well as the trees are included in the living thing list. So you would have heard me saying certain features of living things. So let us see that. These are the features of living things. If all these features are okay for a thing, then that thing can be called as a living thing. Means that, if for example I said about the butterfly, or let us take the example of ourselves, where the human beings are able to do all these features. So let's see the first one, breathe. Can the human beings breathe? Yes, definitely they can breathe. Can the human beings move? Yes, definitely they can move. Do they need food? Yes, definitely we need food to grow. Do they feel? Yes, we can feel. We have so many emotions in us. We can laugh, we can smile, we can do so many things. So many emotions are there filled in us. So next one, respond to stimuli. Can you sense danger? If you touch a hot substance, will you draw back your hands from there? Because you are responding to a stimuli. Then, do the human beings reproduce? Yes, human beings reproduce. Do the human beings die? Yes, human beings die. So these are the features. If all these features, if all these qualities are there in a living thing, definitely we can call that as a living thing. So we'll go back to this last slide. Just check yourself whether all the features what I have just said now, is it applicable to all the pictures here? All the things here. Okay, now let's move on to the non-living things. Non-living things are those things which don't have life. They are not living things. They don't have life. So those things are called as a non-living thing. For example, it is shown a ball. Okay, next we have a cake. Then we have a house. Then we have a chair. Then we have crayons, right? Check with the features what we have learned for the living thing. For example, first one, breathe. We'll check whether each picture or each thing are able to do those things. Okay, so let's see, first one is a ball. Can the ball breathe? No. Can the cake breathe? No. Can a house breathe? No. Can a chair breathe? No. Can a crayon breathe? No. Definitely no. So what happens here? None of the features are suited with any of the things here. So we can say that any of these things or none of these things are living things. So we can name that group as a non-living thing. Let's see the difference now. As I said earlier, living things can breathe, right? But non-living things, they cannot breathe. Living things can move, but non-living things cannot move. Living things need food, non-living things don't need any food. Next one, they can feel, non-living things cannot feel. Next one is they can respond to stimuli, non-living things, they cannot respond to any stimuli because they don't have life. Okay, so they can reproduce, living things can reproduce, non-living things cannot reproduce. Okay, living things die, non-living things do not, because they don't have life. So there is no purpose of saying they will die or not. Okay. Now these are the two parts. We can see the difference with the example. Okay. So maybe a family is there with father, mother, and two children. They're human beings. They are included under living things. Animals, they are also included under living things. Tree, plants, flowers, everything, they are also included under living things. Let's move on to the non-living thing. A rock. It's a non-living. It doesn't have a life. It don't have a life. It cannot live. So, it's a non-living thing. Brush, it's a non-living thing. Table, it's a non-living thing. Socks, car, doll, all these pictures, what is there on the other side are non-living things. So definitely you would have understood the difference between living and non-living thing. Let's have a quick check. Okay, so I will be saying the word and I will be saying the answer also. Before I say the answer, try to answer that question. Is this boy a living thing? Yes. Sheep? Yes, it's a living thing. Shoe? No, it's a non-living thing. Rock? No, it's a non-living thing. Cat? It's a living thing. It has life. Car? It's a non-living thing. Cloud? It is also a non-living thing. Cricket? It's an insect. It has life. So it's a living thing. Fence? It's a non-living thing. Milk? It's a non-living thing. So now you would have understood correctly the difference between a living and a non-living. I repeat once more. Living thing has certain features like they can breathe, they can move, they can feel, they can respond to stimuli, they can reproduce, they will die. If all these qualities are suitable to a thing, it is okay for a thing, that thing can be called as a living thing. If none of these qualities are being apt for that thing, then we can call that thing as a non-living thing. Okay, so I think you understood what is a living and a non-living thing. Next group we have is the man-made things. In the name itself, it shows what is a man-made thing. Most of the non-living things are man-made things. Man-made things means that the things which are made by man. For example, laptop, right? Is it made by? It is made by man. Car, it is made by man. Bag, it is also made by man. What about building? It has been built by man itself. Cake, yes, we make the cake. Man make the cake. Ball, man make the ball. All the pictures, not just you may be knowing more than this, you can share it with your parents, which all are the man-made things, you know it clearly. Okay. Next group we have is the natural things. Natural things are those things which are created by nature. For example, tree, mountain, sun, rabbit, apple, rock, sunflower, right? So these are the things which are created or already there present in the nature. Let's have a quick check based on man-made things and natural things. Here we have some pictures. I'll be reading the picture's name. You will be guessing what is it and I will be answering after that. And you can counter check with the answer, right? So first one is, it's a mountain top with river. It's a natural thing. House, it's a man-made thing, okay? A pond, it's a natural thing. Park, where you go and play, it's a man-made thing. Road, yes, what you said is correct. It's a man-made thing. Hills, mountains, it's a natural thing. Tree, it's a natural thing. Next picture, it's a natural thing. Car, it's a man-made thing. So this is our quick check. Hope you understood what is a living thing, non-living thing, man-made thing, natural thing. And you would have understood the things what are there around you. By learning all these things, you can easily interact with the environment. Thank you, children. We are winding up the video.